It's hard when something that is literally definitive of who you are as a person is just taken from you and you're just like, now what? I definitely saw myself in the dance world long term. And when I was in college, I was dancing like 30 hours a week and my foot kind of just snapped. The realization hit that like, you're never going to dance the same again. I've always struggled with my own stuff, so it like sent me somewhere that I was just like, wow, I really don't like this place. I'm the oldest in an immigrant household. I was born in Mexico, raised in Las Vegas. I was just kind of thrown to school. I learned how to speak English. I've always been the bridge for my family when it comes to interacting with the American world. I helped raise my siblings. My parents were always at work. I didn't have the luxury of being like, oh, I don't want to do this. I just had to do it. Back in Las Vegas, I remember signing a lease and they made us fill out this form saying like, there is a possibility that you will be exposed to lead during your time here, either deal with it or don't. And it was very difficult to communicate that to my Spanish-speaking parents. That was just information I didn't want to give to them, but I had to give to them. Nobody should be okay with this just because we need a place to live.
There is no safe level of lead. In what world is it okay to say that it's cheaper to let some people die than to protect environmental health? It's wrong. It's just fundamentally wrong.
Okay. Hey, Sandlin. Well, come on in. No, I mean, this is reality academia right here. So Jesus has done a good job of keeping track of when there's been exceedances.
I found Mónica on the internet and this woman is doing like research catering for communities of color and underrepresented communities.
Not we won't use drinking water because I mean, no one's drinking it.
And like seeing how contaminants actually affect these people.
What you found when you're trying to do lit reviews.
Most people just said, email me. It was just, you can email me. I was like, okay. It was just something that I wanted to be a part of. And I got in and I was just like, let's go. Tell that girl she really popping though. Stacking bins, making plans. Yeah, she unstoppable. The people that suffer the hardest from environmental issues are usually people of color. The type of work that Project Harvest does brings it to the forefront.
How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Fine. How was your drive?
It was all right. Ready for this sampling?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
The research question came from community members who are growing their own foods and really wanting to know, like, is that source of pollution impacting my residential space?
We are scientists that want to use the information we gather to help the people who it affects.
And then we're just gonna pour the soil here. Good, that's enough.
There are those community members that really appreciate the work that you're doing. People like Miriam.
Soil not irrigated.
There is something about knowing the truth, then you can do something about it.
Inorganic, huh? Mm-hmm.
They're labeled, so we'll know what to put where. Cool. Well, thank you, Miriam.
You're welcome.
I'll see you next time.
Have a good treat.
I had my depressive episode since I was like 16. When I first came to Tucson was like the hardest it's ever been for me. I go through episodes where I'm just like immensely anxious to the point where like it is physically crippling. And I think that kind of comes with being the person that lives in between, you know?
Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8, step, hit.
I know I couldn't let go of the art just because that's everything that I've known.
I see the issue there. Go straight into it. Step left, up, boom. That's better. We'll work on the falling.
After that injury, I helped a friend start a dance company.
We have, an hour, so I want to teach at least a minute. Sorry. Guys, I'm not crazy, I promise.
And it was more so for people who all of a sudden weren't able to dance, so we were just kind of like a ragtag team of dancers.
Hinge, bam. Ooh, yes. I'm a dancer and a scientist. Okay, ready? 1, 2. You can even fall out of the turn, like.
I don't feel like with dance I'm ever limited. It allows me to express myself and all the things that I don't get to do when I'm in the lab.
Everyone has such a unique story and such a unique set of skills that they bring to the table.
And I just wanted to thank the team, to my committee. Thank you all for being here. Today I'm going to be presenting on...
If I hadn't found science and told myself, okay, well, grad school is your next step, I probably wouldn't know a lot of the things I know now.
In communities that neighbor toxic release.
There's so many different environmental issues going on.
For the full and partial body contact standards.
Then the people, again, that are being affected the most are the people like me.
Or lead. You'll see that again, Hayden Winkleman.
I want to be able to eventually develop some form of environmental nonprofit that could help to combat that.
Patient standard.
I am appreciative of science and all that it's taught me. Everything is connected and everything affects somebody somewhere.
He's a very talented student who's not only a scientist, because I will always remind him that he is a scientist, and he's also a dancer.
As he wavers between the noose and the booze, he waits, astute, to the paradigm that has been presented, ready for the next opportunity. It's gotten him far. Will it get him far in the opposite direction? He knows the answer. As he pivots, he sees the sunrise.